So, DXO smartphone rating can be pretty suspicious because sometimes they get it right and sometimes you can't fully trust their overall ratings. And since this phone, the Huawei P60 Pro, is still at the number one spot after several months of its release, I decided to give you my full in-depth camera review after using this phone for 3 months. Now, as usual, during my long-term reviews, I won't be talking about the specs and all the marketing jargons, but I will show you the results and give you my take on each of the photos, but feel free to let me know your thoughts also in the comment section below. Now, let's start off on the daytime ultra-wide lenses. Now, usually for smartphones, there are two issues with this particular lens. Now, firstly, it is not as sharp, especially on the edges. And the second part, which usually always irritates me, is the consistency of the color from the main lens to the ultra-wide lens. But as you can see in these photos, putting both the ultra-wide lens and the main lens side by side, it produces the same image quality and produces the same color reproduction. Now, just looking at these ultra-wide shots alone, you can see that these pictures did not have any barrel distortions and the pictures not only had an amazing dynamic range, but it was sharp from edge to edge. Then going over to the strongest lens, the main lens, from the sharpness and the details for different shades of color were easily produced. And all the pictures that you see over here is a point and shoot manner without playing around with the settings or adjusting the colors in post, as I usually never edit photos for my smartphone cameras. But I have to say that if you love taking photos of your food, this will be your best friend. Now, another lens where a lot of smartphone fails is through its telephoto lens, because even when I tested other smartphone cameras, nothing comes close to this telephoto lens. Now, I'll be showing you two separate photos for the 3.5x and the 10x zoom, since those are the optical zooms. Now, I've seen in these 3.5x zoom images, you wouldn't even guess that it was a 3.5x zoomed in photo because of the performance of the zoom was almost like I was literally standing in front of my cat Luna when she was sleeping. And even in this picture of the building, you can see the textures, which you cannot usually see when taking the picture from afar. Now, if you think that the 3.5x zoom telephoto lens were great, well, look at this 10x zoom images. Now, the details on the Sonos logo and the holes on the speakers, looks like I've taken this photo on a macro lens. Now, speaking of which, I will show you the super macro mode sample shots later, so stay tuned for that. And looking at these 10x zoom images of Luna once again, there is no way I could take in a shot of her this close without waking her up. Then finally, looking at this shot of the Sheraton Hotel in Shanghai, it is also at 10x zoom and you can clearly see how sharp and detailed the images were. Then continuing on to the digital zoom. Here's a photo of a 50x zoom and 100x zoom on that same Sheraton Hotel logo. And here are some photos taken towards the evening at 50x and 100x zoom at W Hotel, focusing on the logo as well. And here's where, although the 50x zoom quality was decent, I wouldn't go past that unless I really need to, because I'm personally extremely happy with the performance of the 10x zoom as seen earlier. But do let me know, do you always take pictures of 100x zoom very often? Let me know in the comment section below. Next, let's look at the portrait mode shots. Now, for objects like food and flowers, it did a very great job on the overall edge detection and subject to background blur. Then taking portrait mode on human was also great with similar high quality results with amazing looking bokeh. Turning over to the super macro mode, since there's no dedicated macro lens for this, thank God for that. It is using the telephoto lens and the camera's app AI that will detect as soon as you place the phone very close to the subject, and it produces some amazing results as you can see over here. Then to finish off the daytime shot, selfie photos on the phone were really great too, and even with several pictures in the shot, it still turned out great without any issues on balancing the overall skin tones, even when this particular shot was taken towards the evening. Now, like the rear lenses, the portrait selfie also had great dynamic range, edge detection, and once again, very accurate skin tones as well. Now, before I show you the nighttime photos that will blow your mind, if you guys are enjoying this video, a nice big thumbs up would be very much appreciated, and a subscription would be lovely too. And if you want to flex your smartphone photo skills, since YouTube does not allow you to post pictures in the comment section below, feel free to join our community Discord channel and let's see the type of photos that you have been taking. All the links will be in the description below. Alright, switching over to the night mode. So the great thing to love about this ultra-wide lenses is using the night mode at night. Alright, switching over to the night mode. So the great thing to love about the ultra-wide lenses using the night mode is the sky's color accuracy. Because I love how the skies are black with nice little illumination at the area of the building. Now the highlights and the shadows were perfectly balanced with no signs of noise at the darker part of the image, where the ultra-wide lens is usually the Achilles heels for other smartphone cameras, especially at night, and that was not the case over here. Now, I think by now, you'd already probably guess and predict how well the main lens would be at night, and your guess is right. Because here are some very good shots for you to see how well the main lenses performed and overall look stunning, especially with the night cityscape on the AI mode as well. But personally, I did not predict how well the telephoto lens performed, because take a look at this image of the Oriental Pearl Tower. Both the 3x2 zoom and the 10x zoom images were stunning, as you guys can see, and you would never predict that these shots were taken on a smartphone. Now, another huge reason to use these telephoto lenses is because the AI detection seems to work very well on the telephoto lens, a bit more so than the main lenses, where it detects and triggers AI actions like the sunset between 1x to 20x zoom to get better enhanced sunset shots as seen in these images. And here's where you can get this particular X-Mage to get the AI to detect to get the best moon shots too. And this could be very apparent when you're switching between the main lenses to the telephoto lens, and yes, up to 100x zoom images, as you can see over here. Now, the portrait mode at night also performed very well too, to all of my and the whole entire team's surprise. Whether it's for objects, my cat, and it did extremely well on humans too, with amazing bokeh being produced with the background lighting and the light shining on the hair does produce a better image separation too, as seen in these images as well. Now, taking night selfies was a no-brainer because even with little to almost no light, the overall image processing created a very pleasing image. And this was the first time ever I was feeling super confident in taking nighttime selfies on a smartphone without the images turning out bad. Next, going into the video recording mode. Now, during the day, the ultra-wide lenses were high in quality with gimbal-like image stabilization, and the main lenses also performed even better. And the image stabilization over here was really amazing too. Then the front camera performed extremely well both from a quality's perspective and the image stabilization too. And just so you know that Huawei is the only Chinese smartphone maker that has 4K video recording on the front camera. And the same can be said for the nighttime videos. And it was really nice to see how well balanced the highlights and shadows were at night, especially since it's on video. Again, something which a lot of other smartphones does not perform very well under low light. And if you're planning to vlog at night, no worries, because I also had similar great results for video recording for the front camera too. Now, of course, if you dive in deeper to the camera app, there are other features like the slow-mo, light painting, which is something that I don't usually use, and I'm sure that a lot of people may or may not use this very much. But if you want to use them, it also works very well. So that's the overall in-depth review of the camera's performance, and with that, I truly believe that DXOMARK score has got it right for this particular smartphone on giving the number one spot for the smartphone's camera's performance. And since there are Google apps easily available on the phone, things like storing the photos on Google Drive or emailing them to the family on Gmail, and even more usage for Google-related apps, there are no more limitations of using a Huawei-branded smartphone. But do let me know what you think after seeing these pictures. A worthy number one spot? Let me know in the comment section below.